Now every gambler knows the secret to surviving is knowing what to throw away, knowing what to keep. 'Cause every hand's a winner and every hand's a loser, and the best you can hope for is to die.
All right, welcome to the Diplomats, here covering the fall and winter of 1911. I have to think that the boxes were checked way ahead of time. The turns went through rapidly. After this next season, there's only one season left. The scramble, as Keith calls it. Let's see if there's going to be a scramble. Are we going to see Norway and Edinburgh or York?
I doubt it. I don't think Riaz is that kind of player, especially if he's going to publicly roast people for trying to throw and then throws himself.
Well, we got the convoy right.
You got Irish right, too. Look at that.
He did force Irish. Yeah, I see that. It's a bit of a headache because of Mid-Atlantic.
Mm-hmm.
But now everything can get covered with Gascony there and Munich going back to Burgundy, which great. Because Italy, I guess, could have had some shenanigans with England. Not that he would, because that's not the way Italy rolls. But
yeah,
if that had happened...
Really claimed the French win a long time ago by not even pressuring the DMZ at all.
I mean, ironically, Gascony could have convoyed directly to Wales.
Directly to Wales.
What did Irish do? Did it hold?
Doesn't have a hold symbol around it. Oh, it looks like it moves to Mid-Atlantic.
Oh, yeah, the red arrow there. Okay.
It was so in line.
Meanwhile, Picardy did go to Belgium. It's a really good guess by Conk to go Holland to Helga, right? Really. That's why I was thinking Baltic would have been better. But I don't even know to what end. Turkey ain't helping Russia.
Nope.
I kind of buried the headline here. Greg took, he didn't take Vienna. Bohemia didn't cut Galicia. Instead, he takes Budapest. That's the end of Russia.
Yep. And he tries to take Greece here, which turned too late. Could have popped that army.
But he got a seven. Now he's going to build an army, I'd imagine. What need of fleets? He's not attacking anybody. He's not going.
Right. I agree. Need an army just in case.
This is the end of Russia also with Romania making it.
Yeah. I don't think Russia can hold the south anymore. It's probably stuck to five.
There's a guess now between Moscow and Warsaw. Can he take Moscow for that to happen? He could take, depending on what Galicia. The game is really, I can't see.
It was over last season.
I'm moving these odds now to the 99.99. People are playing for second. I think that's what Greg's doing.
I was like, I don't think anyone get 10. And France doesn't need to grow. Possibly could. But it's like, where does Turkey pick up three?
Here's the thing. I mean, honestly, Jordan could move Gascony to Spain, Burgundy to Gascony, prevent Portugal from being taken, even if Irish is a raider. So I think Jordan just goes to Liverpool.
Yep.
Probably gets covered. I'm sure Riaz sees that. It goes to Liverpool, and he takes the North Sea, right? He's got three on it.
What? Oh, yeah, he does have three on it.
Kiel can cut Denmark.
Yep. You have two armies to cover all your centers, since you only have to defend them for a year, really.
That's it. It's 1 year.
So you can balance anything.
I mean, the worst case is Turenian going to Lyon and that happening, but that's still nine, and I'm not sure anyone else is going to get to that.
I agree.
But actually, it's 10 because...
Liverpool.
Liverpool's gone. If that, for all that to matter. Otherwise, the French unit can cover me. Although, if there's an army in Venice, you could see a Venice to Piedmont, Turenian to Lyon. Maybe Conk just plays it safe and moves back.
It doesn't really matter. I feel like if he's going to prioritize Liverpool, he probably can have a play on London. I don't think he needs to. There's no reason to risk it. There's very little chance.
I don't know what it is about. As much as we talk about Bradley's tactics, and even though Audacious Hand said there weren't great tactics, I think Jordan's tactics are a little boring, but they're effective. They just keep working. This Helgeland move is great. Really good.
Looks like a lot of flailing. Like, the more I move, the more likely I am to bounce. And if I bounce, more likely to be safe. So he has, it's like a little web.
Yeah. It seems to me that the players are just playing. And that's actually not a bad game here, right? We have 7-7-7, if I'm reading this. Turkey gets no builds. Italy gets a build. I think it has to be Army Venice. I can't come up with any other build that can get anywhere.
It's a free-for-all, though. So now they're at 7-7-7.
7-7-7. Who's their tiebreak? Tiebreak is Bradley.
France has got a tiebreak in Italy's favor.
It's already So that means Greg has to be at 8, right?
Yes. I think he'll probably make it to 8.
I think Greg will get to Vienna.
I agree.
And if you like playing for second, it's not an unreasonable result given this game for Italy. I mean, I think Italy was down to 2 to finish second. But did he go for glory? Not really. He'll say he was limited by geography. That's a lie. Turkey
he played aggressively when he needed to play safe, and he played safe when he needed to play aggressively. needs to reverse this Italy game a little bit.
Turkey might get to eight. Might.
Possible.
I mean, you'd have to take Serbia, right? That's going to be difficult.
That's difficult, especially if you're keeping a raider just.
Moscow, Warsaw, something like that. I mean, Galicia's got a choice between supporting Vienna and Warsaw. He's probably going to prioritize Vienna. I'd be mad at Greg. But Silesia, Galicia. But that could help Turkey, too.
I'm mad that we're talking about the tactics of second place, but
Right. I mean, if these players had any chutzpah. I mean, there are DB9 points, right? That's probably the only thing.
no, Bob changed the scoring. So technically your second, third, fourth, it's all seed. So the only thing that changes is your first place.
Oh, so who was the top seed? It must have been, it's the same thing, right? It's Greg would be, oh, Greg would be second. It's the opposite of the lower power. So Greg would be second because he picked ahead. He would have had the higher score.
Didn't Riaz pick second?
Oh, are you kidding me? Riaz would
Riaz
get
makes,
second.
as long as Riaz is there, yeah, he's doesn't matter. He's gonna be second even if he's eliminated.
Oh.
So you can play for
I don't know,
second.
Bob. I don't like this rule change. It's not a very fun rule change.
He can play for pride, but you're not gonna get DB&I points for second. And yeah,
Then
so
there's no reason to even play. It's all decided, is what you're saying.
pretty much, yeah. Your rank coming in is the rank you're going to be scored for this entire tournament.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Then why are they playing?
I don't know. They should have drawn. They should have drew after the spring when they figured out they didn't have a plan. Now they just seem like they were fast forwarding by just checking the box fast. I'm like, just draw.
Why are we recording?
I don't know, because France has won and we know the seeding for the rest. This is
There's only
just,
one build, right? Because Russia piffed,
yep.
got Budapest piffed. It's only Italy, right?
Yep.
That was a hard one.
Yep, that was difficult.
Jeez. Okay, grades. A triple plus smiley face exclamation point for France. Where are you on France?
Yeah, I loved all the moves. They were perfectly executed. All the bounces where it needs to be. Everything in place to hedge his bets for the next year. I don't think anyone can take anything from him. He saw the danger at the line. He moved to the line. There's no danger there. Everybody else gets an F. Good.
I mean, Russia's definitely losing one here. There's too many armies. You know, there's two on Vienna plus a cut of Galicia. There's two on Warsaw with a cut of Galicia. There's two on Moscow with a cut of Livonia. Like, if the full attack went everywhere, he can only, you know, he can't stop them all.
Right.
He's going to go down one. The most he could do is pick up one with Edinburgh. Can't even pick up two. Riaz might be the kind of guy to convoy him to Edinburgh and then just take Norway in the fall. That'd be funny if
It's a
that happened.
McNamara move. Look like you're throwing and then you don't.
I think Josh's max is seven.
Maybe.
It could be worse. That's his max. I don't think he can get. He can't take anything else. The maximum for Turkey appears to be maybe eight. Maybe.
Maybe. He's got two on Romania and it's empty. Bulgaria can't help it. Eight is
He's
pushing
got
it.
to defend Greece, and South Coast and Aegean can only defend.
Yep. He's got three on Greece, so his only soft spot is Romania. So if he supports in Romania, that means Ukraine has to go to Sevastopol, which means he has Prussia to do nothing. Tap Berlin. I think he's stuck at seven.
I think, although Greg is probably going to prioritize Vienna, I think Greg is at eight. I think we can say he might get to nine, might get to nine through Marseille or Spain. But I think that, I mean, all of that can get covered.
Yep.
Nothing's at risk. I mean, honestly, like Silesia back to Berlin, Bohemia cuts Vienna and then back to Munich. I mean, there's like, and I actually don't think Greg's the kind of player to get help into Vienna
And stab at the same time.
and then stab at the same. Now, I'm saying I've done that. I can do that, but I'm not sure Greg, he's got a code. We don't necessarily always agree with his code, but that part of the code I like. But you know, it's the last season. And Kong knows how to play these things as France. I mean, gunboat, this is all just gunboating here and you know, everything. I don't even know if he'll go for North Sea. He might just cover Helgoland. Covers Helgoland and nothing's at risk. He just needs to
Yeah.
make sure he doesn't lose it.
Holland to Helgoland, Ruhr to Holland. Kiel is pretty much a stalemate on its own. Been south-bouncing Berlin.
He may very well go Irish to Liverpool, English Channel to Middle, and who cares if he loses the channel?
Yeah, because he can always bounce it out of Brest. Yeah.
Right. Doesn't matter.
And he can always
Nothing
support
can be
Belgium
done.
with Burgundy. Yeah.
That's probably what'll happen, which means Greg can't take Spain or say. Greg has too much respect for Jordan anyways to try some. Jordan's certainly gonna cover.
But he just does he deserve that reason.
He does deserve it. I can't see Italy getting to nine.
No.
I can see him getting to eight.
I think that'd make France a little uncomfortable if they got.
I mean, a lot would happen for Berlin to be under threat. Nothing can happen for Munich. Somehow, in order for anything else to be under threat, they need to take Helgoland. Maybe, depending on North Sea. North Sea's gonna.
Well, I mean, if Warsaw goes to Silesia with Prussian support, and Galicia goes to Bohemia with Vienna support, and Venice goes to Tyrolia, you might could pop two armies right away and take both of them. We know that's not going to happen. It's not impossible.
Well, Munich's going to be left open. One army will get somebody will retreat to
Assuming
Munich.
that all, yeah, I guess he wouldn't backfill. Kiel's going to go to Denmark. We'll probably go to Holland, and Burgundy's probably either going to hold or go down to gas. So you're right; they'll have one retreat. Still have four armies on the line.
It's kind of disrespectful to France not even to draw.
Yeah, it's like if you think you got to win, sure, keep going, but just
I mean, if the
draw.
game was in 1915 or so, I'm not saying I draw,
Right, I
but.
agree.
There's too much. I mean, you just count them up. It's 24 to 10. Okay, 24 can beat 10 in diplomacy. He's not on a stalemate. But 24 ain't beating this 10 in 1 year. They're not even getting 10 down. Okay. Well, apparently not second place in the tournament, but second place on this board is Bradley at 7. He didn't lose Greece, and he could have. I'm gonna give him a B plus. That was risky what he's for apparently, but he's trying to win. I think Bradley is trying to win.
I'll give him a C.
Why so low?
Because I grade a C on good tech. Anything else? He's an ally. Does he have an ally? Did he make progress? He didn't. So no. C. Because C
Josh
is
is
not
in
bad. C is passing. Even though
J Josh, our former leader, told me C is passing, and that's like the end of my school year. Like if I got
C
Ben Sullivan got a C,
plus, your tactics were above average.
Hari Curry time. Ben Sullivan got a B plus. It was Hari Curry time. All right. Russia is in third place on this board, and I think can only go down. I think Russia will be at six, if not five, probably. I mean, I don't know. If we're just grading this year, I'd probably give him a B, but his multiple Fs prior to this caused.
Yeah, it's a D, just because he went down. I mean, he got England back on side for a fun convoy. That didn't happen, but if he would have worked on that a year or two ago, they might have taken France down one.
I think he needed to realize that they were never getting anything off Turkey, and he needed to attack Italy. By the time he realized it, well, he never realized. It's too late. Greg realized that that could have, which is why they fault him. It's his grade, played super conservatively, but he went up. He is now fourth on the board, but looking good to be second. And give him a B plus.
I'm gonna give him a B. He actually has an ally in France. Person he shouldn't be an ally with is the board leader, but at least he has an ally. Nobody else really does. So B. He
Riaz
grew.
didn't lose anything,
And he grew,
his
yeah.
but I'm gonna say his plan in Denmark. I actually want to give him a grade up for not convoying Norway to Edinburgh. I'm proud of Riaz for not doing that. I think he would have done it if he thought that the game could have been won by Russia. I don't, and that would have been. So I'm gonna give Riaz a.
I give him a B. He tried to work with what he had. I appreciate that. I think he could have totally convoyed in Edinburgh, but if it doesn't matter, there's no real reason to do so. And as soon as the Russian line broke with Italy, there was no reason. I think they needed the Italian pressure. Russia just lost the popularity game here. People want France to win.
Will Riaz be losing one? Because I can see if the center goes, I can see London going or Liverpool.
It's possible, yeah. Like I said, you can go Irish to Liverpool, English to Wales, and force the North.
Will we see Greg and Piedmont and Lyon?
Or we could just force the North. No. His opportunities to move were a long time ago.
And
If
that
he moves,
wasn't even much of an
if he
opportunity.
moves now, it looks petty.
Will Greg be in Vienna by the end of?
I think so. I think there's a good chance.
I don't think he's going to be in Greece.
No, Greece is impossible.
Not impossible. Ionian could go to,
Improbable.
if he got
It's
to Eastern Med in Ionian, then he can take.
improbable, but yes, yeah, it's possible.
If I know Bradley, no, I think he might get to know. I think he might get Bradley. I mean, I think we all see the issue with Bradley might try and out guess him one more time. It has to be in the spring.
The thing is that Greg always pushes for position in the spring and prioritizes the centers in the fall. It's just a predictable pattern that Grayson has blocked every time. If he tried to go for Greece in the spring, Grayson has always left it unprotected.
It's almost like they're polar opposites in how they.
Well, I think Grayson's
Greg,
just
yeah.
is literally thinking in fold. He's like, he's got to play conservatively and do the correct methodical way. I just think that Greg is predictable.
It would be funny if Ionian moved to Aegean
But
here.
if he did that, then Bulgaria probably goes to Aegean too. It'd be Aegean to East, Bulgaria to Aegean, Greece to Bulgaria.
Yeah, I mean, you could do that. I think Italy, the more I look at it, I think gets to 8.5.
I mean, Greece is possible. It's definitely possible. But I think Bradley has a good chance of bouncing it out
It'll be interesting.
if the trend can continue.
It will be interesting. Okay, well, the most boring question of the show: who will win Olympus Season 2 main event?
Volpe has won because he got eliminated before this mess happened.
Oh, man, you stole my line. I was about to say that, but I'm gonna say Jordan. I think I've been with Jordan the whole time, except for the time I cheated on him with Turk. I think that. Okay, anything more to say?
Nope, that's it.
Good night.
Good night.
For a taste of your whiskey, I'll give you some advice. You got to know when to hold up, know when to fold up, know when to walk away, know when to run. You never count your money when you're sitting at the table. There'll be time enough for counting when the dealing's done.